What would you do if you got a text from your friend telling you to pack your bag, grab your passport, and meet him the next day at 3 p.m. and this happened?
Going to the Sahara Desert.
No way! What?
Got a couple questions? Well, let me begin.
Okay, so it all starts 3 years ago, when I uploaded my first ever video on this YouTube channel. My videos weren't great at the start, and not many people watched them.
So yeah, cheers for watching, and I'll see you next week.
But there were a few people who always believed in the message of my channel and would send me words of encouragement to keep going. One of them was Jack. And after doing an Insta stalk one day, I saw that Jack was actually a really talented artist who was also chasing his own dream of becoming a full-time singer. Wait up, I thought that what Jack was doing was really cool. So, we met up for a pint in London, where we both connected on our shared belief that if we worked our asses off, there might actually be a chance we can make each of our biggest dreams come true. And 8 months later, Jack's songs were getting played by famous DJs in clubs all around the world, even having one of his debut singles streamed on the biggest radio station in Britain. However, despite all the W's I'd been seeing externally, after catching up with Jack last month, he told me that he was quite down in the dumps, as he had just broken up with his long-term girlfriend a few days ago. But I didn't want that one bad thing to take away from all the really cool things Jack had been doing recently, which was why I decided to surprise Jack and bring him along on this experience. So, I invite you now to buckle up and fasten your seatbelts as I take you along on this crazy adventure and on to phase one. The assembly.
Basically, I can't tell you everything, but I can promise you, you will not regret this. Can you meet me in London on the 7th of December and you'd be back in London on the 10th of December? Okay, so what you'll need to bring is a small bag, like, you know, just a backpack with 3 days worth of like clothes in it, and a passport.
Okay.
It's a good thing, I'll tell you that. It's a good thing. It's not like an unpleasant experience, I don't think.
You didn't think. Okay. Let's do it.
All right. See you then, bro.
And before I knew it, 3 days later, it was the morning of the trip.
Alright, this is the morning I surprised Jack with a trip to Africa. I keep my hands on myself.
We agreed to meet at King's Cross at 2 p.m, giving us exactly 1 hour to then travel to Stansted Airport and try our best to not miss our flight.
So I'm on the train down to London right now. I still have no idea what's going on.
He genuinely has no idea what we're doing.
And at long last, after many days of anticipation, it was the time for the big surprise.
Hey, there he is.
I'm excited for today.
I'm so confused.
Okay, are you ready to find out where we're going?
God. Yeah, okay, come.
We are going right now. We're actually quite very late for our flight. We're going to the Sahara Desert.
No way!
What?
That's sick, man.
What?
Yeah.
We're going Northern Africa.
We need to go to the airport, we're late.
Oh my god. So is this coat needed?
I didn't want to throw off the scent too much. Mr. Blue Sky, please tell us why you had to
head away for so long. Jack and me have decided to mute all of our uni. It's done. For these 2 days, we've got to.
It's a cost, unfortunately, of £55 per person.
What?
We made it through. And now we're going to Northern Africa.
What's happening?
And as I sat there on that plane, I couldn't help but think, damn, I was lucky. In this day and age, the same price of a roast, we can go and explore a completely different part of the world. That for free, we get access to this thing called the internet, which for the first time ever has given everybody and anybody on the planet the ability to learn almost anything they want to. That we get to be alive in a time where whilst the world may feel like it's collapsing around us, there's never actually been a better time to be alive.
How is it to live here?
Tu parles français?
Yes, yeah, I'm bit of Marrakesh.
Ah, and tu adores habiter en Marrakesh? You like?
Yeah.
Ah, okay. What's your name?
My name is Najim.
Najim?
Yeah.
Seb, good to meet you.
Welcome.
Thank you.
Good
have a good day. Bye.
He gave me a little kiss.
I saw that.
I think it's.
Jack and me are climbing a mountain. 1,500 meters.
We then went back to the flat, where we decided to spontaneously try and match with a local on Jack's Tinder to try and get an insider's perspective into Marrakesh.
Tika,
she's actually
like
music.
Hey!
Hey!
How are you?
Hi, Jack.
Thank you so much for offering to show us around.
Perfect. Yes. Okay, we'll see you then.
What?
We'll see you there in about 30 minutes.
Yeah.
What's this restaurant? Chow.
Are you skill?
Yes.
Jack and me were just saying it's been a
pretty
incredible few days. We're just looking up stars at night.
What a world we live in.
What a world.
Atika was really nice and turned out to see the world in quite a similar way to how Jack and me did. So she agreed to show us around the desert the next day to try and help us not get mugged off. And in my opinion, so she could try and work some game on Jack.
Hi, Jack.
Oi, oi.
But if there was one lesson which I learned from this video, it would be
to go there.
Because I think that it's easy to start seeing the world in a certain way when you only stay in one place. It's almost like your brain forgets how much else there is out there in existence right now in this beautiful planet. It can become too easy to see your bleak, grey hometown as the only world you live in. But in reality, it's hardly 1 trillionth of this planet. With the cost of flights nowadays, travel is more affordable than ever. And there's great solutions to travel for free if you're already broke. So, my message would be to get out there, create memories you'll never forget, and as always, don't live to regret. Real danger, this girl ain't saying home. But I'm strong, I know how to get out. And I'll find my way, cause it's love, real simple, and that's how it works. Oh, so won't you just give it up, cause you don't understand. Big it up, but you don't understand. And it's really nice, cause you don't understand. So big it out, cause you don't understand.
The wizard.
So I'm studying Chinese.
Oh. Oh, right. Okay.
Slightly rogue.
Can you change video?